Hey guys, what's up? What's going on? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a sequel to the video that I did not that long ago, which was looking at my first Sephora order. So today I'm gonna be looking at my first Ulta order. If this is the first time you're on my channel, what's up and welcome. My name is Kate. I'm so excited to have you guys here today, and I would love for you to subscribe and join my little YouTube family. The button is down below. Also, make sure you click the bell to turn on post notifications. That way you're notified every single time I upload a new video and you don't miss out on anything. Okay, so we are just going to get right into this video. Sorry. Keep clapping. I'm not a seal. Once again, I am shocked. I thought when I was looking at my Sephora order that it was possible. Maybe I just shopped online at Ulta more and that's why I didn't have any like earlier purchases, but I was like really shocked when I opened up this app and saw that I didn't place an online order on Ulta's website until 2016. Like, what in the world was I doing? I guess I was just shopping in person. That's just so weird. I could have sworn that I would have made an online purchase before 2016 at Ulta. Like, who am I? That's so weird. Regardless, we're gonna be looking at my first Ulta order. I only had two things, so we're gonna look at my second Ulta order as well. They were within a few months of each other. So I remember these two products came out right around the same time and everyone was hyping both of them up. First thing was the the Modern Renaissance palette. Love her. Don't use her nearly enough, as you guys can see. I am a serial palette buyer and not user. So unfortunately, the tragedy is this. I bought the palette. I do really like it. I don't know why I do this, you guys. It's like, I buy these colors and I just feel like I'm going to love them, and I really do, but for a while, I was such in a rut of using the same thing over and over, just slapping on my makeup, not allowing myself like that creative moment to sit down and come up with a look. I've been doing that a lot more lately. Like this look today, I was really feeling this look. I did film this. If you guys wanna see the tutorial, it's kind of a tutorial, but it's like a chatty, get ready with me style tutorial. That video probably went up before this one, but I'll link it up in the iCard as well as in the description box down below. So this, I actually have just started, well, it kind of matches my hat. I have just kind of started using this again lately. I used this in a video not that long ago, and I really loved the way the look came out. I just forgot how amazing the Anastasia eyeshadows blend. These colors are definitely a little bit more in my comfort zone now than they were like at the time this came out. I feel like I'm definitely allowing myself to be a little more creative and expressive with my makeup. Whereas I got in this rut of like only doing neutrals, which I still love. Do not get me wrong. Your girl loves neutrals. That is what I will always and forever purchase and be like my favorite thing ever. With that being said, I have been enjoying using a little bit more color lately, even if the colors aren't that crazy. Because to be honest with you, these are pretty neutrals. I'm talking more about like these brighter things here, but for some reason I just wouldn't use that. So I've dug out a lot of old palettes lately and have been playing around with some different colors, and it's been a lot of fun. Kind of going back to answering the question, would I repurchase this? If I ever ran out, absolutely. I have so many palettes, I feel like it would be almost impossible to run out of one, but I do really still love this palette. I think it's a great one. Yeah, ABH for the win. They always come through with good palettes. The next thing I don't have, because I actually did not like this product at all. This was something that was really hyped up by a lot of people. It is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow. I don't know why this just didn't work for me. The color I ordered was fine, which is shocking. I really suck at ordering foundation colors online unless I already know it's gonna work for me. I'm just not that great at shade matching myself. Shockingly enough, I mean, I know I'm such a makeup lover. You would think by now I'd be able to figure it out, but for some reason I can't. This, for some reason, just didn't work for me. It was like too slick. I have kind of like combination skin, and this just didn't really work for the oily parts of my face. I usually love L'Oreal. This was kind of a surprise that I didn't like it. This one specifically just did not work for me, so I would not repurchase that. However, I know so many people love that foundation. It just, I don't know, I just couldn't get it to work right. But I feel like I'm definitely an oddball out. Most people that have tried this liked it. So that was actually it for my first Ulta order. I'm gonna go into the second one just because this would be a very short and uninteresting video if I only did one. My first order was, let's see, January, February, March, April, May, June 18th of 2016. That's when I ordered those two things. And then The next order was December 5th, 2016. The first thing I ordered is Shape Tape. Shocker, loved this stuff. I think at this point when I ordered this, I had just gone through my first bottle of it and was repurchasing. I still love this. Surprisingly, I don't have any of it on hand right now. I've been really loving lately the Too Faced Born This Way. This has been my go-to concealer. I use the shade Vanilla. Anyway, all I was saying is that I've just got so many concealers right now. It makes zero sense for me to purchase any right now, so I'm just kind of using what I have on hand. That was that. The next thing I ordered in this particular purchase was the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, which I still use and still love. I have this on my makeup table right now. I will tell you, the first color I ordered right here was not the right one. I ordered the shade Vanilla, and that was too yellow for me. I needed something a little bit more warm. Okay, anyway, this color, I am using Warm Nude. This is actually the perfect color for me, but I love this still. It's really, really great. They obviously just did a huge collab with Jackie Ina and expanded the shade range, which was awesome. Even the concealers, to my understanding, she had nothing to do with the concealers, but they have a really amazing shade range on the concealers too. So that's just kind of like my favorites right now. All right, the next thing was some Hoola bronzer. I guess I was restocking. This is literally an all-time fave of mine. This might actually have been the first high-end bronzer I ever purchased, and I still love and use the crap out of this. It is just such a great color. I have not found any other bronzers that the color is that perfect for me. It's just a really great, like, all over, like, face warmer upper, but also it really can, like, contour. It's like not too warm, not too cool. It's just really, really a perfect bronzer color for me. I have repurchased this many times. I have been sent this many times from Benefit, and I just like constantly go through them. So yes, I absolutely will still repurchase. I will continue repurchase for like always until the end of time. So the next thing was the Precisely My Brow, which you guys know I obviously still use this. I just posted an updated brow tutorial and was using this. This is just such a good brow pencil. I feel like this and the Anastasia Brow Wiz are my favorite brow pencils of all time. Right now I'm using the shade 3.5. I usually use the shade 4. This is just what I had on hand. They recently extended their range of shades, and so Benefit sent a bunch of these over, and I had just gone through my shade 4, so I was like, okay, I'll try 3.5. I feel like both of them work like pretty close to the same. I think one of them is warmer and one of them is cooler shade. I can't remember which is which though. Here's the brows. Okay, the last thing in my order was the Benefit Roller Lash, which I am still a huge fan of. That's what I have on right now today. This is one of my all-time favorite mascaras. I love, 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 love the way it applies. The only thing, which it doesn't stop me from using it because this is like truthfully like my third or fourth tube of it, but the only thing that bothers me a little bit is that it doesn't completely dry. It's almost always a little bit like waxy or tacky feeling. I don't know how to exactly describe it, which it's good because it doesn't ever flake off. But I guess the only downside to that is like if I'm applying lashes or something, sometimes I like to pinch the corners of the lash, you know, just to like seal the deal. But it kind of like sticks the lash to the mascara. I don't know. There's just something about the formula, but I think the formula is what makes it work the way it does. So I don't know. It's a very small little bone to pick with this, but I do really love Roller Lash. It just works great. It gives you the most beautiful volume and length. Oh my gosh, does anybody remember back in high school when Bad Gal Lash, or maybe you weren't in high school, but I was. Bad Gal Lash was like the thing. Like if you had that in your makeup bag while you were in school, you were like the shit. I always wanted that and I could never afford it. And one of my friends always had it and she would like let me use it, which now thinking back is like kind of gross. What did I know? I was like 15, 16, 17, 18, whatever you are in high school. But we just thought we were so cool using the Benefit Bad Gal Lash. This has taken the place of Bad Gal Lash. I like Roller Lash definitely better. Bad Gal Lash is still really good though and will always hold a really special place in my heart. So I think that was actually it for this order too. It looks like I did get a holiday bag I think it was literally just a makeup bag with any $45 benefit purchase. So that was actually it for this video. I wanna know what you guys had in your first Ulta order. I had so much fun reading the comments on my Sephora order video, which I will link that as well for you guys to watch. But a lot of you guys were sharing what was in your first Sephora order, which was really cool. It was fun to kind of go back and see what everyone was using and loving at the time or wanting to try out. So I definitely wanna hear what your first Ulta order was. I would love to know what you guys got. Let me know if you got any of the same things that I did in this video, or if any of these throwbacks were nostalgic for you. Just let me know. Let's chat in the comments. Thanks so much for watching and spending a part of your day with me. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to like and subscribe before you leave, and I will see you in my next video.